Hey guys, it's Gail with PopCulture.com here with Phil Vassar, who has been one of my favorite singers and songwriters for over 20 years.
You're so sweet.
Well, thank you for letting us talk to you today.
Oh, well, of course.
Okay, so we have lots of things I want to go over. First of all, songs from the Cellar, second season.
Yes.
Talk about that show, because it was kind of innovative when you started it last year.
Well, it was, you know, it's been a lot of fun doing it. We've had a crazy cool guest, you know, like Tommy Shaw. I always said if I could just get my neighbors to do this, it's such a cool little deal. But, you know, Peter Frampton came in and Steve Cropper and had Mike Tyson and Carrot Top. I mean, it's a very, you know, wide array of guests. But I like the fact that it's just different that way, you know. And talk about music, we talk about life, pop culture, whatever we talk about, everything. You know, it's been a lot of fun. You know, we just had Dennis Quaid on. And you know, so it's really going well. And I love it. It's amazing how many people... you know, love music. I mean, music is, you know, it's a thread that just kind of ties us all together, really. And so I've enjoyed learning a lot about folks and interviewing them, actually, you know, which is kind of fun, you know, that end of it.
I was going to ask you that. Do you think it's because you have so many stories behind your songs that you were interested in hearing other people's stories? Or what gave you the idea to do the show?
Well, that, you know, because I, you know, John Rich and I were actually talking, had this little conversation in my cellar downstairs, And I said, man, this is gonna be cool. It's gonna be a cool show or whatever. So I just got some cameras. You know, it was just on the fly, really, and it just kind of turned into this whole thing. And being in this town too, you know, we've had so many, you know, folks just right down the street. You can't throw a rock without hitting an artist or somebody, a songwriter or an actor or something. So it's been really, really fun.
Any dream person that you want to have come on that hasn't come on yet?
Elvis. I keep calling.
Oh.
You know, I don't know. There's so many. You know, I mean, it's Billy Joel's and you know, the Elton John's and, unattainable, you think sometimes. But you never know. These kind of things just sort of work out sometimes. And, you know, I just think it's, my favorite stories are, you know, when I'm sitting there and I hear, you know, Billy Joel talk about, you know, why he wrote Piano Man or this or that or, you know, these folks that paint these pictures and through music, and I love it.
Mm-hmm. It kind of reminds me of like the Bluebird vibe. I love going to the Bluebird as much to hear the stories as to hear the music.
Right.
Because everybody wants the stories behind the songs.
Well, it is, and I think the Bluebird is a fascinating place. Mm-hmm. It was something that was so indigenous to Nashville and kind of started here. You know, we all have been there, played there, and, you know, just the stuff that's come out of that place, you know, And it's always fascinated me, you know, and so it's very cool to sort of strip it down. My cell is so small, you know, you can't help but be intimate and tell these stories. So it's very cozy.
So you're a big wine drinker.
Well, I don't know if I'm a big wine drinker, but I like good wine. I Kix, of course, lives across the street, and he's very big, you know, on that stuff. He knows a lot about it, and you know, I've learned a lot in the process of doing the show and then playing, of course, out in Sonoma and Oregon and Washington. We have great wines in this country. It's not just, you know, probably the best wines in the world, for sure. And it's sort of taken over. Even Virginia, where I grew up, huge, huge wineries up in New York State. And, you know, it's just, it's fascinating to see how much people love it. And I know you like it.
I do. I mean, we might have talked off camera.
Right, saying.
Any chance there would be a Phil Vassar wine coming out?
You know,
a lot of artists are doing it now.
They are. You know, it's pretty cool. People do that or liquors or it's a big business, the beverage business. And I've been in the beverage business a long time. And you never know. It could happen at some point, you know.
We might have to come back and talk about that.
Here's here. Drink me. Drink my river. Here it is. Have some of me.
No, call it that. Okay, we have to talk about new music too. Stripped Down just came out.
It did, yes.
Talk about the album. It's a really interesting album.
Yeah, it is because, with technology now, with Pro Tools and all these things, and, you know, we have the technology to use about 1,000 tracks, and everybody seems to do that anymore. So I just thought it would be fun to just break it down to the bare minimum. And I think a good song, stands on its own merit, really, you know, and doesn't need to be overproduced. And some songs really need to be overproduced, I can tell you. I think, but for me, it was just fun just to sort of break it down, keep it simple. You know, I cut my records here at my house anyway, and it was just fun just to go down there and sit down with the piano and play these songs and see what happened. I really love this record. It's fun.
we were talking off camera too about how busy you are because you just released the album and you're doing not one but two tours.
Yeah.
Dude, you have the Hitsteria and the Strip Down tour.
Yeah, and the Strip Down, we just don't wear clothes, which is a different deal.
Different audience.
No, it's a. I think my mother said, she goes, son, it sounds like a stripper tour.
Bless
which,
your mom.
Which maybe that'll help. I don't know. No, but it's or hurt in this case. But it's been great. We just did 21 shows in a row on the Strip Down tour, and we kicked back into Hitsteria in middle of March or end of March, and so it's been great. And we were on that Christmas tour with Lone Star for those 18 shows we left on Thanksgiving and got home on Christmas Eve. So it's been a busy, busy 3 months, and you know it's been great. And shooting this little television show, which has been a lot of fun. So yeah, I'm not taking any time off anytime soon. It looks like.
Is there going to be some time off? Because that sounds like a lot at once.
I see a beach in my future.
Yes.
Yeah, I really do. I love it. You know, that's my thing. That's my zen place, and I get away and just get away and go to the beach and sit there. And for some reason, that breeze just makes me go, ah. And I think I probably will need that very soon.
It's very rejuvenating. I'm all for the beach trip. We'll come.
Okay, good. Yes.
20 years ago, your debut album came out, but you were already a songwriter
before that. Yeah.
So does it feel like two decades? I remember being at your album release party, by the way.
Really?
I had just moved to town.
Wow. My mother got mugged at that. Isn't that funny?
That's a terrible start to the...
She literally got mugged at that deal at gunpoint.
And oh my gosh.
So I know. I'm like, what happened? And nobody told me until afterward.
But that's, terrible memory.
What a horrible story.
But that aside.
But she's okay, you know. But it was a weird deal. And but yeah, I mean, it's hard to believe it's been that long. You know, I mean, it's flown in some ways, and then it seems like 100 years ago in some ways too.
Do you have if you had to choose, are you a songwriter who sings? Are you a singer who writes songs? Where's the delineation for you?
Well, I think some days it's either. Okay. You know, I always consider myself a songwriter, you know, first, but I was singing way before I was songwriting. And, you know, I always think about that. I was talking about that the other day about guys like Elton John or Billy Joel and Hornsby, who are such, you know, virtuoso piano players. You know, they're like these incredible piano players that write songs. Mm-hmm. And I'm just a songwriter that plays piano. So it's a different, you know, in that way, you know, but it's, you know, it's hard to distinct, you know, to the distinction between, you know, being a songwriter, being an artist, being an entertainer. I love all of them, you know, and I love being in the studio. I love creating something from nothing, you know, and then the culmination of it all is having that audience sing back to you, and you just stop and they're singing the whole thing. It's like, wow, you know, and that started with this idea. And so it's pretty cool.
Is it a different fulfillment if you hear somebody else doing your song, like another artist, versus when you do your own?
Well, I think as hard as it is to get songs recorded anymore, you know, you know, it's a real blessing to, you know, you think about how hard it is to just to get a song cut, and then to have a song actually released as a single, and then for it to be a number one song or whatever, all the stuff that goes into that. And you know, I wish I didn't know it went into it. Now I do, which you know, which is, it's a lot of work, and you know, a lot of tricks behind the scene, believe me. And you know, it's not that little business where you just write a song and it's a hit. You know, it's not. And but all these years later, you know, I still, you know, if you turn your radio on and your song's on, you just go, oh wow. So you still get that feeling like it just happened, you know. So it's really cool.
Do you have a favorite song you wrote?
I don't have you know, it's usually the latest one. You know, you go, oh, this is great, you know. And but I mean, some songs, you know, when you're playing shows like this Strip Down tour, I don't have a set list, or any of my shows I have a set list, never. So I just kind of take requests all night. And people will call out these songs from, I've had, you know, 10 albums over my career with all these songs recorded. And of course, you go, oh my God. I mean, it's a train wreck sometimes. You try these songs you haven't done since you recorded them. But man, it's been a really, really great experience, you know, kind of revisiting these songs again.
Okay, so I'm almost afraid to ask this question, but we have the album that came out. We have two tours. We have a TV show. Mm-hmm. Anything else happening in 2020 besides the beach trip? Anything else?
Well, I'm dancing a lot.
Okay.
No, I mean,
Dancing with the Stars coming
up. No. That was, we talked about that earlier in my career. We thought it was a bad idea. And
Still a bad idea.
As my knees are, it's a horrible idea.
Anything else coming up this year?
You know what? It's just, I'm just enjoying what I'm doing. I think, you know, working on the show's been great and something different. I think you're always trying to sort of reinvent yourself and do different things. It sort of keeps you. I'm ADD anyway, so I'm all over the place, and so it's really good for that. You know, you're doing the tour of the band, you're doing the tour by yourself, you're doing a TV show, you're doing all kinds of different things, and you're writing songs and just trying to stay creative. I love all of it. I really do.
And you're going to come back and talk to us.
I'd love
you're
to.
You're going to come play in our studio, right?
I would love to,
We're going to make it happen. For more info and all your other favorite artists, please visit popculture.com.